action. Good morning. It may be afternoon when you see this, it may be evening, but here it's morning. So I'm going to be doing a seated class for you throughout. So before I was just doing a warm-up, then a main section and a cool-down separately, but we're going to put it all together. So the whole thing will be about half an hour, and it's for those of you that do the balance and strength classes. You might need, let's have a look, something like this, a resistance band, but if you haven't got one, you don't have to use it, okay? We can do everything without it. The other thing that me and my glamorous assistant Billy have done is we've filled two bottles of water out. We've also got two tins of beans. Chopped tomatoes. It's just something to add a little bit of resistance for some of the weight section. But if you haven't got it again, don't worry, we'll just use body weight. Now, are you ready? Because we're gonna get started. So you might wanna pause me while you get your bits and pieces together. We want a dining chair, somewhere safe, somewhere that you can see me clearly, and then we'll go from there. If you need a little bit of extra support, then have two chairs. So when you stand up, you've got something to hold on to. So go get yourself ready. I'll get myself ready and I'll see you in a minute. So, I'm ready. I'm hoping you're ready. You may find yourself sitting down nice and comfortably now. So remember, the first thing we're gonna do is music, maestro. We've got a little bit of 50s music for you. You can always let me know if you don't like it. Now, while Billy, my glamorous assistant, is getting the music going, I'm gonna show you how to get into that working position. So we're gonna just walk this bottom forwards into the front half, the front third of the chair. We're gonna place those feet hip width apart and we're gonna sit up nice and tall. So you can see there's a gap. There's a gap between my back and the chair. Now, if you get tired, you can always come back into it, all right? But I don't want to see you doing the whole session from that position. Let's use these core muscles to really stabilize the trunk. Okay, I'm going to bring my chair back to face you, and we're going to start with our normal warm-up. In that working position, we're going to start just by squeezing the shoulders up to the ears. We're gonna relax those shoulders down. And we're gonna think about sitting nice and tall. We've got that chest nice and open. We're gonna do one more little shoulder squeeze. We're gonna relax those arms down. Now we're gonna keep these sitting bones on the chair, and then we're gonna just let these arms relax. We're gonna draw that tummy button in slightly, and we're gonna lift the rib cage out of the hips. That might be a little bit too loud, Billy. Good, that's perfect. So we've got a bit of Peggy Lee in the background. Good. And we're keeping those shoulders relaxed, shoulder blades sliding down the back towards the bottom. So remember, we're not lifting that bottom off the chair. Now, let's see if we can just pick these feet up. Just start to get a little bit of movement here. So I want you to keep your feet moving while I move my chair backwards. Ever so slightly. Okay, so we're just gonna keep those feet gently moving and then we're gonna bring it down. Now, let's see about bringing these arms underneath the chest. We're gonna take a roll of these shoulders. Slide those shoulder blades down that back. We're gonna take a little twist one way. Good. And we're gonna take a little twist the other way. Wonderful. So remember, these knees stay facing forwards, this chin staying in line with the wrists, and that's looking good. Good. Nice relaxed shoulders. And then we're just going to relax those arms onto those thighs. We're going to take this little warm-up for the ankle. So we're going to place the heel and then the big toe in the same spot on the floor. Good. Good. So we've got a bit of Nat King Cole in the background. And then we're going to change legs. So we're going to take that heel, toe, heel, toe. I'll change Just making sure we've not slumped back into that position. And we're just going to think about getting a little bit of arm movement as well. And now we're going to smile. Because when we smile, everything seems a lot better. Maybe not as false as that smile. Okay, let's relax the feet, relax the arms. We're going to think about those shoulder rolls again now, okay? So I'm going to just roll these shoulders up to the ears, slide those shoulders back down. Good. Remember, if anything hurts or anything feels wrong, if you're not really feeling like it, maybe now's the time to just relax, find the movements that work for you, don't push into the ones that don't. Now, let's see if we can just start to warm these arms up a little bit. So we're just gently pushing those hands away from the chest. We're not taking them too high. Okay, we're just pushing away, then we're gonna bring those arms back down. We're gonna see if we can take some little taps in front of us. Little taps in front of us. Good, just starting to get those legs moving. We're just trying to get some movement throughout that body of the blood. Good. Okay, now let's see if we can take that heel tap in front. Good. So we're keeping that nice strong trunk. Nice strong trunk. We're going to do two more of these. And then we're going to bring it back to center. Okay, I'm going to turn and face you. This chair's quite heavy, so it makes quite a noise when we're doing it. Now, we're going to see if we can take a little circle with this elbow. Now, if those shoulders are sore, just make it smaller. We're going to do the same on the other side. Little circle with these elbows. Good. And then we're going to bring it down. Now, we're going to see if we can come up onto tiptoe and bring those heels down. So we're coming up onto tiptoe, bringing those heels down. So if I was to turn and show you from this angle, coming up onto tiptoe, we've still got that nice long spine. You're looking beautiful. See if you can look straight ahead, not like me. Now I've got my head at a funny angle. Now, let's see if we can lift those toes off the floor. So we've got those heels down, we're lifting the toes up. Good. Heels down, lifting those toes up. You're trying to show me the bottom of your shoe, but keep your heels on the floor. Good. One more if you can, and then we're going to relax. And then we're just going to go back to this little walk on the spot. Okay, we've done some chest presses. Now we're going to take some little punches. So we're walking, punching those arms forwards, nice and steady. So we don't want you to go too fast, too soon. Okay, we're punching down now, and then we're just going to see if we can bring those arms to shoulder level, bring those arms back down. So just gently drawing those arms in front of you and back down. That's looking good. Now this time we're going to bring it down. We're going to see if we can just bring those arms to the back of that chair. We're going to lift your chest, draw that chin into the back of the neck. We're going to release and we're going to take that tension out of the shoulders. Super. Now, let's see if we can go back to those little taps in front. I'm going to bring my chair back a little bit more. So taps in front. So you can see the multicolored bottom of my shoe, I'm hoping. And if you can't, maybe I'm not putting my heel down. Good. Now, you may feel comfortable adding a bicep curl. Good work. So, we're going to make a fist, open out those fingers. Make a fist, open out those fingers. We can slow it down, squeeze. So we're bringing in a little bit of hand and wrist strength as well. Squeeze, and then we're going to release. Now, let's see if we can take that heel in front of you. We're just going to draw the toe up towards the ceiling. We're sitting nice and tall. And then only if you feel ready, we're just going to gently lean forwards till we get a little stretch down the back of that straight leg. Then we're going to come all the way up. Try not to go too far because we are warming up. I'm going to show you from a different angle now. I'm going to take, oh, I've just kicked my exercise mat. I'll show you from this angle. I'm going to take this foot in front of me, drawing that toe up towards the ceiling, then using this leg for support, or using both legs, keeping that back as long as you can. Love. talk it out. So, we're going to go back to that little punch now. See if you can punch up for me a little bit. Good. See if you can punch forwards. See if you can punch up and forwards. And then we're going to relax those arms down. Now, take that shoulder roll. We're going to see if we can walk one hand, just reaching over that shoulder. And you can support it if you prefer. You can release. Let's see if we can take that shoulder roll again. Let's do the same on the other side. So this is all about being able to reach back of the neck, hair, and we're going to release. Good. So let's just shake those arms out. Let's shake those legs out. One more little mobility exercise for the ankles. What I'd like us to do is just circle that big toe one way. So imagine you're drawing a circle. And then we're going to do the same the other way. And we're going to bring it down. Let's see if we can do the same on this foot. Circle. And back again. Right. So, we're moving towards the end of our warm-up. So you should be feeling a little bit looser. The one thing I haven't done, I forgot to do, and I'm going to do it now. We're going to see if we can just drop the chin down towards the chest. We're sitting nice and tall. Lift that head. And then we're going to turn that head one way, come back to center. Let's drop that chin again. We're going to go the same way, okay, so you don't get dizzy. Nice and easy does it. And then we're just going to drop that chin down towards the chest. Lift that chin. We're going to look over the shoulder that way and back to center. Okay, one more time. Again, you're just listening to your body. We're not forcing anything. Good. Okay, now, little bit of movement, little bit of mobility. What we're going to do now is you're going to just relax the shoulder, but you're going to draw this elbow back and then bring it here. Showing you from a different angle, we're just squeezing that elbow. And what we're going to do is we're just going to gently follow it with the head. So when we're all allowed to get in the car and drive again, this is our reversing the car movement. So we're just following that elbow with the head. Don't worry if the elbow goes further than you can see. It's fine. Let's do the same on the other side. So we're just watching that elbow. Good. So it's a really nice bit of rotation in the spine. Really nice bit of movement in the neck. And of course, we're working those upper back muscles that always need a little bit of help. Let's relax out and we're going to get started. So we're coming from the end of the warm-up into the main section. Now I've taken my feet a little bit wider apart. Remember from class, this is brilliant, but just watch out. I've got the wall here. You might have someone next to you. So what we're going to do is our wide base sway. We're taking our weight onto this sitting bone, weight onto this sitting bone. Now notice I'm not leaning with my head. It's coming from this part of the body. So we're just transferring the weight from sitting bone to sitting bone. Sitting bone to sitting bone. You'll notice these legs having to work a little bit as well, and you'll notice these core muscles having to work. Now, we can add a little bit of arm movement. If you feel confident, pain-free, and comfortable with this, you'll notice the muscles here really having to work hard. And so to improve your balance, we want to improve your core strength, your core stability. And that's what we're doing here. And then we're going to bring it down, bring those feet back to hip width apart. Now, we're going to walk on the spot. So when we're walking, we've got this strong trunk. When we're sitting, we can bring the arms in and we're going to keep those shoulders nice and relaxed. We're just taking those elbows forwards and backwards. Good. And we're just looking to get a little bit of breath going. Just a little bit more, well, just a bit faster. If you can't talk, you're working too hard. And then we're going to bring it down. Now, our next little thing, we're going to take a step forwards and we're going to come back. I'm going to show you from this angle. So we're just taking a step forwards, pushing with this foot, this leg, coming back. Stepping forwards, coming back. This is our big step forwards. So when we're standing, I liken it to stepping off the curb. Okay, we're going to do alternate, one at a time. Good, one at a time. And we're going to bring it back. We're going to walk it out. Now, this is our knee lift, where if we're standing, we're taking those knees a little bit higher. Seated, we don't want these knees too high. You're going to get really sore hip flexors. This is going to help with everyday activities like climbing steps, just stepping over things, general walking. Good. And then we're going to see if we can take some little taps behind us. Little taps behind us. Good. All right. So that's going to form part of our standing midsection. If you're not up to standing today, you're just going to do it as I've been doing here in a seated position. Ah, hello! No exercise video complete without Sam Tagg, the exercise referral dog. Okay? That's it, isn't it, Sam? All right, so when you're ready, guys, we're going to think about standing. I'll say that again. We're going to think about standing. So I've moved my chair into a position where you can see me. I'm in that working position and those heels are underneath the knees. Really important. Remember, if we're here and we try and stand up, it's almost impossible. Even back here, have to really make an effort. So if you can walk yourself into that front third of the chair, bring those heels under the knees, all of a sudden, it gets a lot easier. So, make sure you've got something you can hold on to when you stand if you're prone to maybe losing your balance a little bit or if you get dizzy when you stand up. Keep yourself safe. Now, we've got those feet hip width apart. We're gonna say 3, 2, 1. We're gonna stand up, stay seated if you're staying seated. We're gonna take a little bit of a walk on the spot. Now, I'm going to see if I can just move with my feet first, and I'm going to move to the back of my chair. So I'm taking as many steps as I feel comfortable, and I'm going to move to the back of my chair. Now I'm just going to move it so you can see me. I've got my chair here, and I'm walking on the spot. So I'm going to turn to face you. We're going to pretend my chair is here, but I'm actually going to move it so it's out of the way. So I'm holding onto my chair and I'm lifting one foot at a time. Okay? That's good. Lifting one foot at a time. Now, if you feel confident not holding on, we can start to walk on the spot using these arms. Notice these elbows are moving forwards and backwards. If you need to hold onto that chair with one hand, we can take those elbows forwards and backwards on one arm. You can change arms, okay? Or we can hold with both hands. And then we're just gonna steady those feet. Now, first thing we're gonna do is those little taps and in. So I suggest holding onto that chair, tapping diagonally, bringing it back in. Good. Tap and in. Good. Tap and in. We're going to do 4 and 3. And that is looking very good. We've got that strong core. Beautiful. Now, we're using this little section for a couple of minutes, something just aerobically. So it's something that's good for your heart and lungs. And then we're going to move on to a little bit of balance later. Now, we're just going to walk on the spot. If it's getting too much, have a little rest, but keep your toes wiggling, or take the arms out and just make it slower. If you're feeling comfortable with the pace you're going at, and you can talk, we can keep going. And then we're just going to relax those arms. Now we're going to hold onto that chair. I'm going to show you from this angle. We're going to see if we can just take those little taps behind us. So we're squeezing the bottom in, okay, using those bottom muscles, and we're taking small taps behind us. We can hold onto that chair. If you feel that you don't need the chair or you only want to hold on with one hand, we can add a bicep curl. But listen in to how you're feeling. Okay, listen into that breathing. Got nice relaxed shoulders, you're looking good, and then we're gonna bring it in. Okay, let's see about those knee lifts. So again, you may wanna hold onto that chair. You may want to just hold on with one hand. You may feel comfortable just maybe using these arms as balance, or by adding that bicep curl to make it a little bit more challenging for that heart and lungs. Good. So now we're going to slow it down a little bit. Imagine that field of sticky mud. So we're challenging your balance, challenging those core muscles. You may have to hold on to that chair, and we're going to bring it down. And we're just going to gently walk it out again, gently walk it out again. Now I'm going to show you from the side, so hold on to that chair if you need it. Again, we're going to see if we can just use these big muscles in the back of the leg. We're just going to pick these heels off the floor. Remember, it could be that little tap behind you. Excellent work. We're going to do 4, 3, 2, and 1. Let's bring it back to that walk on the spot. And then we're going to finish off with that wide base bend. When have I ever been able to say wide based sway? So these feet are a little bit wider. We're standing nice and tall, but we've got softness in those knees. Now we've got that chair for balance. We're gonna take the weight into that leg, weight into this leg. Now notice what happens to the heels on my foot if I want it. So on a small scale, we're just transferring that weight. You may feel comfortable with knee bend and lifting that opposite heel away from the floor. If we're holding on with one hand, we might bring in one arm sway. Remember, watch out who is beside you. We don't want you going to hospital with a broken wrist. Okay, so we can just make that little knee bend and pushing up. We're transferring that weight side to side, one foot to the other. Really great for your balance. 3, 2, and 1. We're gonna bring it down. Excellent work, everyone. Excellent work. So we're just gonna relax a little bit. Bring that heart rate down. So now, you are gonna need to hold on for this one. We're gonna see if we can do a little bit of balance using that chair in front of you. We're gonna work on those calf muscles. So we're gonna see if we can do a little heel raise. We're gonna lift the heels off the floor, pause at the top, slowly back down. Now, if your balance is feeling good, you might take one hand away. You might even be able to take a couple of fingers away of the hand that's being supported. You might find you can take both hands away. Just watch out we're not doing that. Really see if you can drive those heels up, keeping that pelvis nice and stable. One more if we can, guys. And then we're gonna bring it down. And we're just gonna gently walk it out. Now, you know what I like to do when we're in this position is put in a sneaky stretch. So we're gonna press the heel of that back foot towards the floor. Remember, if the heel is at 6 o'clock, the big toe's at 12 o'clock. That's at the back foot. Oh, it's a great stretch of those calf muscles. Let's do the same on the other side. Good, I'm just checking that that heel's not turned in. Good. Great. You can really lean into this chair. You can actually take that front foot forwards a little bit if you want to increase the stretch. Make sure that's on warm muscles, guys. Okay, we're gonna move those feet a little bit. Now, how about a little bit of balance on the move? So, I'm gonna move my chair back a little bit. I'm gonna pretend I've got my chair here. We're gonna see if we can start to take some side steps. Good. So we're stepping, bringing that foot across. Notice I'm not banging my feet together. I'm just stepping, bringing that foot across. Stepping, bringing that foot across. Good. That's super, super. We're just going to do about three more and two, and we're going to do one. And then we're going to see if we can do some static balance. So I don't fall in front of you. I've got my chair to my side, but you can have that chair in front of you. Now, we're going to see if we can lift that foot off the floor. I can see my little timer. We're going to hold it for 10 seconds. Now, if you need to come in and out of it, that's fine. Just remember, I've put that cup of tea on top of your head. We don't want to spill any of it. And then we're going to bring that foot down, move the feet a little bit. Let's do the same on the other side. So we're just going to lift that foot off the floor. Now you may find you can take one hand away. Okay, try not to. If you're wobbling, bring it back, okay? We're just going to train the muscles to become stronger in a supported position, then gradually increase. And you might be able to take one finger at a time away until you take the other hand away. Let's bring it down, everyone. Walk it out. Good. Walk it out. Lovely. So, little bit of dynamic balance. So remember in our warm-up, we were taking that big step forwards. So already I'm too far forwards. So I'm going to bring that chair here. Now we've got our chair in front of us or to the side of us, depending on your balance levels. We're going to take this step forwards. We're going to push back to that start position. So do you remember in class we talk about stepping off that curb? And we're going to do it just with one foot only. Stepping off that curb, making sure that heel is down, making sure we're actually taking some weight into that front foot. So you could, remember sometimes we practice that movement. So, stepping off the curb, the bus is coming, so we've got to get back on the pavement. Let's change legs. So we're stepping forwards and back. You are looking brilliant. Now what I'd like you to do is be aware of what's going on here as you're stepping. What we don't want is that tummy closing off and you looking at your feet. We want to keep that nice, strong, long trunk. Good. So, we'll do about four more of these. It's brilliant, guys. I'm feeling a bit restricted by my chair situation. And one more. And then what we're going to do is just walk it out a little bit. We're going to do that again. But we're going to change legs. We're going to do alternate legs. I've got my chair for support, and we're going to just take those small steps into the chair and back. So you're having to really use these trunk muscles, leg muscles. Good. That's great. Superb, everyone. Superb. Now, that's great. Should we do one more either leg? Okay, we're going to do one on this leg, one on this leg, and we're going to bring it back. We're going to walk it out. Okay, let's do a little bit of strength, and then we're going to come back to our chair for the rest of our strength. So we're going to do our little squats. Now remember, we don't want you doing that. That's not a squat. That's going to hurt your knees. What we want you to do is sit down into those heels, come back up, squeeze the bottom at the end. So we want those knees bending in line with that second toe or the big toe. Chest is lifted. We can hold onto that chair for balance. And we're going to come down. Now remember, you can use, if you prefer, we can come around to the front of the chair and we can use that chair. So up to you, but we're going to do 10. So I'm going to use the chair, but I'm just going to make sure this is pretty heavy, this one. So if I did fall heavily, it's not going to fall backwards. If in doubt, put it against a wall. So then we're in no doubt that that's not going anywhere. I could use my blanket box as well. So are we ready? We're going to see if we can do 10 push up through those heels. 9. Good. That's great. Now try not to do this. Okay, keep that chest lifted if you can. Push your bottom to the back of the chair. That is superb. Okay, I've lost count again. We're going to do five more. Five, push it up. Four, use those arms if you're starting to get tired. Pull them backwards. Good. Last one. And then we're going to just slowly, as slow as you can, lower yourself down into that chair. Whew. Relax for 4 seconds. Okay, that was great. That was really great. So, we're going to do 2 exercises now for the upper body. And if you haven't got a band, don't panic. We're going to get into that working position, sit nice and tall. It's this upper back row. So we're working the back muscles between the shoulder blades, back of the shoulders. So remember, we do this in class, we're squeezing the shoulder blades together. If you don't have a resistance band, what you could do, this is where our tins of beans come in, you could add a little bit of resistance holding onto these. If your wrists don't like it, do not worry. Just do it without. Okay? So I'm going to use my tins of bean. I'm going to relax the shoulders. I'm going to start 10. Now I'm going to show you again what you do if you've got the resistance band as well. Okay? Now you should be on about 7 now, guys. So we're going to do 6. Lovely. 5. Make sure we breathe out. 4. Good. Really squeeze those shoulder blades together. Keep those shoulders drawn away from the ears. Lost count again. All right, let's try 2 more, shall we? Squeeze. And again. Remember, if it's too much resistance, take the hands a bit wider. If you want a bit more, you can take them narrower. Right. How about a press up? Put my tins down. So this time we're going to take our resistance band around the back. So somewhere about there, as if you were drying the mid part of your back. We're going to relax the shoulders away from the ears and we're going to push the band away from us. So if I show you from this angle, I'm sitting tall. Notice those arms aren't going too high and I'm trying to get full extension if I can. Now, if you haven't got the band, I'm going to give you 2 alternatives, maybe even 3. We can imagine we're pushing something away from us. Just imagine pushing, and it's surprising how good that is. We can use our tins of beans. Good. Keep a nice strong wrist. Try not to hold it with that nice strong wrist. Push. Okay, you might have some light dumbbells. Try not to push too high. The other alternative might be if you have a wall that's secure. Move. We're going to just stand with those feet against the wall. We're going to come in and we're going to push away from centre. We're drawing that tummy button to the spine. So, pick the one that suits you best and we'll go. So let's see if we can do 10. I'm going to give you a moment to get into position, relax the shoulders, see if you can gently draw that tummy button in, and we're going to push, we're going to control that movement back. So we're not allowing that band just to snap us back. Good work, everyone. So we're pushing away from center, controlling it back. Good. And again, push and bring it back. We're going to do 3. Have I lost count again? I've got no idea. I might need Billy to help me count. He's gone. He's in a coma. He's lying on the bed. And last one. And bring it in. Good. I've just noticed we have Sam Tagg there. He's watching. He's very impressed with you all. Well done. Takes a lot to impress him. Now, we're going to finish our leg strength with the band around the foot. So I'm going to show you it without the band and with the band. If you know what you're doing, go straight into it. Those of you who've never seen me before will be thinking, what on earth is she talking for? So if you haven't got a band, this time I'm going to let you sit back in the chair. We're just going to let those heels rest on the floor. If you can, draw your tummy button in and just get that lower back connected to the chair. Just let these legs relax. And we're going to just simply squeeze this thigh muscle. Hold for a few seconds. Bring it back down. Good. So we're just going to squeeze that thigh muscle. Lengthen the leg. Feel these thigh muscles working here. Good. So what we're going to do is we're going to aim for 10 on each leg. All right. So it's really important we just try and lengthen at that knee joint without locking. So try not to snap. And we're just using the weight of gravity so these legs can just relax one at a time. If you do both together, you may find it hurts your lower back. Now, those of you who've got the band, we're going to get into working position. We're going to take the flat of the band over the front part of that foot. She says shifting so you can see. We're going to walk the hand down the band. We're going to sit up nice and tall. Lift that foot off the floor. Secure those hands. And we're going to lengthen. So let's see if we can do 10 of your chosen exercise to strengthen those leg muscles. Make sure that knee bends in line with that big toe as you bend. Good. And we're just really, really keeping the shoulders relaxed. Strong core. Good. Breathing in. Breathing out. So when we've done our 10 on this leg, we're going to change legs. And we're going to do the same on the other side. So that balance is really important. If we do something one side, we want to do the other side. And then we're going to bring it down. We're going to do the same on the other side, my friends. So let's walk those hands down to the band. Lift up. And again. So again, if you're doing this without the band, we're just changing legs, doing the exercise I showed you just a couple of minutes ago. Nice, strong core. And we're just lengthening through that leg. Good work. So this is going to be so important in keeping those muscles strong, particularly when we can't get out and about as much as we'd like. So we're going to do our exercises at home, and we're going to be okay. So when we come out to this period, we're going to be strong and fit and ready to face the world. Okay, lost count again, but that's no surprise for you guys. Okay, we're going to bring it in. And we're just going to start a little bit of a cool down. So I'm going to get you to move the feet a little bit. Move the feet a little bit. Just wash out any lactic acid that might have just built up from that strength work. Okay. Now what we're going to try and do is I've come a little bit closer. You might have a tea towel if you haven't got a band, something like that. We've just scrunched up this band. We're going to see if we can strengthen those wrists a little bit. So, as if you were wringing a dishcloth, we've got one hand on top of the other. Notice I'm starting with my elbows out and we're squeezing. So we're going to do 5 or 6 this way. You can do more, but just make sure you don't sort of hurt those wrists. Sometimes I inflame mine if I overdo it. Then we're going to change that hand position. Elbows are in and we're going to twist out. So again, just a few of these, and you can do these, in a way, it's better to do them a few more regularly than lots every fortnight, because you'll find that usually just aggravates the joints. Good. Okay, let's relax that band away. Let's throw it next to Sam, and then we're just going to see if we can roll these shoulders. So we're in our nice, strong position. And then we're going to relax the shoulders down. Now what I'd like you to do is just let these arms swing a little bit. While you're swinging, I'm going to move my chair back so you can see my feet. And you may have stopped swinging by now, that's okay. So what I'm going to get you to do is take this hand onto the shoulder opposite. We're going to hug that arm in. Good. Sometimes I like to just gently drop my chin to the chest. Sometimes I don't. going to release. We're going to do the same on the other side. Good. Excellent.
The heavenly touch of your embrace tells me no one could take your place.
And then we're just going to take that little squeeze. While we're doing that, remember that length between the pelvis and the ribs. Now we're just going to take those little toe taps forwards. I'm hoping you're not as bored as my son is. I think he's just fallen asleep. Alright, we're going to take that foot in front of you. We're going to see if we can draw that toe up to the ceiling. So this is that stretch for the back of the leg, the lower leg. Now we're going to sit up nice and tall. We're going to keep that back as straight as we can. You'll feel it throughout the back of the leg now, so you can take yourself here, wherever you like. Keep that chin drawn to the back of the neck. And then we're going to come all the way up. Just move those feet a little bit. We'll do the same on this side. Let's just check you can see me. So we're drawing that toe up to the ceiling, lifting that chest towards the straight leg. Good. And then we're going to come all the way up. We're going to walk it out. Lovely. Okay, you're almost done. So what we're going to do is we're going to bring those hands behind you. So this is about stretching out those chest muscles. So if you were doing this standing, you might be able to take those hands to the base of the spine, squeeze those elbows together. Seated, we're just holding onto the back of the chair and then just drawing those shoulder blades together. Good. Lifting that chest, release. Let's shake it out, my friends. Let's shake it out. Now, we're going to finish this session. We're going to walk one hand over this shoulder. We're going to see if you can give yourself a little pat on the back, and you truly deserve it. And we're going to breathe out. And then we're going to release. Good. We're going to do that again. But this time, we're going to reach, relax this arm. You can hold the side of that chair if you need to. Breathe out. I know some of us have got really painful shoulders, and if that's the case, just go as far. If this is your point of tension, that's okay. That's brilliant. Reach down that back, gently push that elbow to the ceiling, and then we're going to release. We're going to do that again, and then this time we're going to extend through that elbow. So we're sort of stretching those back muscles. So whatever you've been doing, whether it's not very much at all, take care. And we're just going to keep these joints and muscles gently moving. Now let's finish off. I'm going to just ask my little music man to turn the music off, if that's okay. So we're going to sit nice and tall in your chair. We're going to sit back and we're going to relax. And we're going to focus on that breath out. So if you want to do the arm movements, that's great. But just relax. And we're going to think about just gently breathing in. And then we're going to slowly breathe out. And as you're breathing in, we're just imagining that air gently moving down into the belly button. And as you push that breath out, see if you can breathe out through your mouth without trying too hard. And we're going to take one more breath in. And lovely. Big sigh. Well done. Well done, my friends. So, all I can say is that was fantastic. And normally now at this point in our sessions, we might be thinking about getting a cup of tea, cup of coffee. Jeff, you might be looking longingly at those biscuits. So, we are going to turn off and we're going to make sure we make ourselves a drink and just give yourself a little treat. It doesn't have to be a biscuit, by the way. What I meant is a sit down and a little rest. And we're going to try and stay as active as we can every day. So I am in touch with a few other video providers, if that makes sense, and we can do that. I'll let you know of them all. Anyway, I'm signing out, and lovely to spend some time with you. Bye-bye.